Hello YouTube, this is MikeyPlays18 with another Ben 10 figure review, and today I'm showing off my original Ben 10 Alien Transformations figures from Bandai and G Collections, and let's get on with the review. First of all, let's start with the one who's starting them all, Ben Tennyson himself. Here we have his Ben Tennyson right there with the Omnitrix on his wrist. He first appeared in World War 10, the very first episode, way back in 2005, from 2005 to 2008, original classic series. Here we got a good face sculpted from Bandai. Let's get a close up the Omnitrix. Very detailed. I love how they capture like it pops out of the cartoon look. He is voiced by Tara Strong in the original classic Ben 10 series. So let's get focus. Here we go. You can move his arms. Articulation. There you go. So, anyway, let's put him back here. And let's take a look at the first transformation he transformed in the first appearance in the episode, Heat Blast. I love how Bandai did well with these figures than Playmates. Playmates did pretty good too, but I love the sculpting that Bandai is getting for. Here we got his Heat Blast close up, and you got the Omnitrix on his chest. Everyone loved Heat Blast because I love Heat Blast. I especially love his voice actor, Steven Bloom. He really brought that character to life. And so often. He first appeared in Den No. 10. Very first transformation that Ben transformed into. The start of the whole original classic series. I miss those days. Back in 2005. I would do anything to go back in time. To the year 2005 and start watching it. And here we go. Got his feet right there. The flame looks great. Let's get a close up look of the head. Pop right out of the cartoon look. He can shoot fireballs from his hand and create a massive forest fire. That's a lot. And he's also a Pyronite from the planet Pyros, I think that's what it's called. Correct me if I'm wrong or something. And let's take a look at Wildmutt. Oops, I'm trying not to tip over the figures. He's also Ben's second transformation, and then there were 10 in the Omnitrix on its right arm, the gauntlet, I think. His mouth moves. I love how they capture these figures, even though they're great or not, but they're very great. Outstanding, Wildmutt has this popped out of the cartoon look, and you can move his foot or his arms rotation. I don't know if you could turn his head, but let's see. I guess you could turn his head a little, so. Okay, so let's put him way back. And he's also a Vulpamancer. And from the planet Vulpin. And he can sense out, like, his powers can sense out, like, every time Ben uses him, he can, like, sense, like, he uses sensors. He doesn't have eyes, so, like, he smells, like, he, like, finds you when it snows. Like, doom, 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 doom. Like, he uses, like, sensors to sniff out his foes. And to, like, way like into a situation like if he smells you and tracks you down, you're in big deep for a big slobber and deep trouble. So let's get to Diamond Head. Here we have his Diamond Head, one of my favorites out of the three, and he also appeared in then there were 10 crystals. First of all, that was ice first, but it's diamonds, like crystal shards. He resembles the Tetrax, I think. And he's from the planet Petropia, and he's a Petroshapian. Petroshapian, if I recall. So, he got diamond on its back. Wow, Bandai did really great with this figure. I'm really impressed. He's got like this pop out of the cartoon look. Like, kind of like Tetrax. But he's not Tetrax. He's Diamond Head. Even his live action form is pretty impressive in the Ben 10 Race Against Time movie. Pretty neat. Like, they're, like, actually living crystals. Real crystals. I see what Bandai was going for. So, you can, like, turn his head or move his legs or his arms. See? Try to get him to stand. And let's take a look at Accelerate. Here we have his Accelerate. He also appeared in, and then there were 10 as well. So try to get the camera to focus. Here he goes. Especially, I don't have the mask for this Accelerate because this is the battle version. So, I might have to get like a new one because my dad hates online shopping, but I love online shopping. I'm really desperate to get out of this place. I'm really desperate to get out of my dad's place. I can go to Hollywood, like live there, or stay in somewhere in Texas. But I need a Hollywood agent because I'm thinking of becoming a YouTube celebrity too when I'm doing those things because I'm losing my benefits. So I'll do anything to be famous and for me and my dogs to have a better life. I would like to have endless amount of money someday. Then me and my dogs could have a better life. Like, we live in a nice mansion with nice people. And have maids and butlers that can take care of us. So, here you have his Accelerate. And you see the Omnitrix symbol on his chest. You see his hands. Oh, and his wheels. Right there. The camera's not really focusing today. So, kind of blurry. Let's see, I can. So anyway, Well, it'll focus. It's just don't want to. So anyway, he's a connoisseur. That's his race. So he has the power of speed. Like he can run at the speed of light, like this. Don't you mean we gotta run? Even at the and he's voiced by Jim Ward, who I looked up to a lot. And he also did the Ice Titan from Hercules. If you don't know who Jim Ward is, he does amazing voices. He was the Ice Titan from Disney's Hercules, one of the Titans that Hades command. One of Hades' monsters or henchmen or something. Well, he wasn't a henchman. Only Pain and Panic was, so. You gotta love Jim Ward. He's such amazing. He's such an amazing voice actor. I look up to him. I hope someday I get to meet him. Don't bite my finger. Like you could turn his head, or you could turn his tail too. See, okay, now you got a better look at the face. Okay. Try not to knock them over. So here we have his next. We have his forearms. He appeared in Washington, D.C. And trying to stop Dr. Animals. I think T-Rex. I think he fought the T-Rex. I'm not sure. So he got the geometric symbol on his right or his left shoulder. He can move his like arms. Here's a close up look. Like his arms. I love the details on this figure. The red and black stripes and white. And he's voiced by Richard McGonagall in the original. I love how he brought that character to life. Sounds bad. Hey, Grandpa, you know. I love his voice. He was also on other shows too. And he's a tetraman. And Forms is a tetraman. I think he's from the planet Kairos. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right. So he's big and bulky and he has super strength. He can even throw a school bus at his enemies or at Kevin 11 if you want. So anyway, let's get on to Stinkfly, the stinkiest alien of them all. And he is voiced by D. Bradley Baker, who also did Wama back in the back and Spitter. When we get to him when we're done, so Stinkfly I don't know how to pronounce his species because it's like saying every time the alien species of their home planets and spelling their home planets out. Like, I don't know how to pronounce the saying and stuff. So, anyway, Stinkfly could, like, shoot goo, like out of his eyes. I don't know if he could do it from his mouth. So, he got sharp wings and its legs and its tail right there. I think there's head and the wings can move. See, the wings can move. And the arms can move too. and the legs. His like legs and arms and wings and his head can move, but not the whole body, I don't think. I'm not sure, so he kinda like has that pop out of the cartoon look. Like every Benson figure does have that. Anyway, let's put him back here. So he doesn't tip over. So let's get on to upgrade. Try to be careful because some figures are really tender. They can like fall down. So anyway, here we have his upgrade. He's a galvanic megamorph. He's from the planet. I think he was Galvan B or Galvan Megamorph. Well, his planet's next to Gray Matter species. So, Upgrade is also voiced by Tara Strong, who did the 10-year-old Ben Tennyson in the original series. So, like every time he goes into technology, like he fuses with it, it like get out of hand, like, and he's in control, like anything, like a car or a truck or a bus, anything that's green, and even a tank, like shooting lasers, like he gets into a lot of technology. That's his power, like he fused with it because he's like a living galvanic technology organism or something. I'm not sure. So here we go. Close up his body. His head turns and his arms and legs. He got the Omnitrix symbol on his chest. So anyway. Okay, we'll just put him back here. I'm afraid he's gonna tip over. That's what I'm worried about. So anyway, let's get on to Gray Matter. Here we have his Gray Matter. He's from the planet Galvan Prime, and his species are Galvan. He's got the Omnitrix symbol on its back. And he's very small, unlike all Galvans, and they're very intelligent. And also the creator of the Omnitrix Asma. So he is voiced by Richard Horvitz, who also voices Alpha 5 from the Power Rangers, Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. If you guys don't know who Richard Horvitz is, he's a great voice actor. He did Gray Matter from Ben 10. He's also Alpha 5 from Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. He's also Invader Zinn, like the Nickelodeon show Invader Zinn. If you haven't watched that, if you guys are not familiar watching it, I recommend go watch it like on the internet or watch cartoons online. You'll be able to see his ton of work. So very impressive. Hope someday I get to meet him. Because I'm a voice actor too, because I love to do voices, and I love to be a celebrity, because I really want to be a celebrity so bad. Then I can have my own Hollywood agent, then I can get out of my dad's house for good, because usually I'm not getting along with him. So anyway, and Gray Matter, I think his powers is to crawl into a hole. And he fixes technology, like uses his brain. Like he is very smart. And when there's something in trouble, he thinks about it right away. So look, his head and his arms and legs can move. So anyway, let's put him back. He's very smart, and he can, like, fix anything, like, do anything if he put his mind to it. So, anyway, let's get on to Ripped Jaws. Here we have his Ripped Jaws. I think he's from the planet Pisces, or Pisces. I forgot what species it is. I don't know if it's Pisces or something. It's been a while since, maybe I could look it up, I'm not sure. I'll probably have to do that in my next video, so. Yeah, it kind of looks like one of those monsters in the Finding Nemo, like where Dory and Marlin went deep, deep down in the ocean, and we saw something that looks like Ripjaws and stuff. So his mouth opens, his arm is articulation, I think 360, and here's his like legs. You have the homage trick symbol on his right or left hand, chest or something. So let's put him down. And he's a really good swimmer. He can catch his fish. If he stays on dry land all the time, like he'll like I don't know, like dry, like the sun like dry suffocate him or something. So anyway, so if he stays in water for a really long time, that's no problem, because in its mermaid form, like he's a really good swimmer and he catches fish like big time, like to stalk his prey. So anyway, let's get on to Ghost Freak, since Halloween's coming up. I love how Bandai did well with these figures. They did pretty awesome, like it's so bright, like I couldn't even get upgrade on the Ghost Freak to focus. So I'm going as fast as I can. And my dad's at work, he's working late, so he doesn't know I'm up, so. Okay, so there we go. I guess this is the best way you can focus Ghost Freak. He has the Omnitrix symbol on his chest / right or left side belly or something. I see you. I try to do a great Steven Blum impression. And he's voiced by Steven Blum, who also did Heat Blast and Vilgax, and also you may not know him as Toonami from Toonami Jetstream. Steven Blum is one of the best voice actors of all time. I love his voice a lot. I'm glad I got to meet him. He's such a nice guy in person. You guys will love him. Me and my mom love Steven Blum. Good times, good times. So I'm just trying to get Ghost Freak to focus. Please focus. Okay, that's how he's gonna focus right there, if I put it on. So he is an ectoneurite, alien ghost species. And he has the power to possess people, like the circus freaks. That was the scare. That was not actually Ben. So, anyway, he's a really cool looking character. He has that pop out of the cartoon look, like spooky, I guess. Anyway, so he's from the planet Anarphatos in the Anar system, where lots of spooky ectoneurite henchmen of the scares, and lots of his species. Oh, there we go, we got him focused right now. I guess he only could focus right there. Yeah, sometimes my camera doesn't like to focus on each of the characters' moments, so. Anyway, so. Let's get on with our next alien. Let's get on with Cannon Vault, my favorite roly-poly. And anyway, so Cannon Vault is like, it's the 11th alien in the arsenal of Ben Tennyson. So he likes to roll in a ball like an armadillo. Or like a turtle, I'm not sure what you call it, so. And his head doesn't move, but his arms and his leg moves. I really like it. The yellow, black, and orange, and white. See? His arms move, but not his head, not his whole body. Because he's such a big figure and all, so I have a hard time adjusting. So, and he's an Imperia Powerota. He's also, and his own planet's already destroyed, like it when it stinked by the Big Tick, like in the episode The Big Tick, like when those other alien from not from Earth or something told that we already destroyed your planet, so it went extinct, so poor cannibal species. And let's get on to Wildvine. Wildvine is a carnivorous plant, and I don't know what species he, I think he's a Floridian or Flora reading, and I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, so it's hard to pronounce the aliens' home worlds and species, like whether you get the name right or not. So he kind of resembles to a Venus flytrap, Wildvine, and he controls like plants, like his powers draw seeds at his enemies until the plant grows out and holds the target down and stuff. So anyway, so I gotta see how much. So his head moves. This comes off as well. So his arms and legs move. Great for articulation. So. And let's get on with Ben Wolf, or Blitz Wolf, if you like to call him. Here we have his Blitz Wolf, also formerly known as Ben Wolf. He is a great figure, and also, there's also an Omniverse version that is about to be made soon by G Collections. I probably will get him in comparison, so. They mistake Ben from a Yenodushi, so Ben Wolf is a Loboan. He appeared in the episode Ben Wolf. He has green eyes and the Omnitrix symbols on its chest torso. His head moved, the tail comes off, the arms and legs move. You can like pose them or something. I don't know the head moves, but correct me if I'm wrong, so. Here we got perfect, good-looking Omnitrix symbol. And his powers is like to howl at the enemies like, "Woo!" And I think his other powers like scratch his claws at his enemies. I think he scratches his enemies and yells at them a real Levon does. So anyway, I think he's from the NR system, anyway, from like around Ghost Freaks and Ben Mummy or Ben Victor, whatever you want to call it. So let's get on to Ben Mummy, my favorite out of the trio. Ben Mummy is a Dakufin. Dakufin and from Anarkufos, I think that's how you call it. My camera does not want to focus today. I love this figure a lot. I fell in love with it when Ben started to get more aliens. Because here are the bandages. These are pretty... These can be, like, loose completely. Like, if you ever lost them. People just like super glue them because you could really lose these bandages really quickly. Like, you can't find them. You don't know where to put them. Because these could be loose easily. So, here's the Omnitrix symbol on his shoulder. Great. I love this figure. Bandai did a great job with this. I'm so happy. His arms can move. His head can move too. But I think his legs can move, but not very much. But see? Really good looking figure. I'm very proud of you, Bandai. Very proud of you. And he's voiced by Richard Green, who's in the original. Really cool voice. He sounded like a hippie guy, like from the 80s, I think. So, here we have his Ben Victor. And he's also voiced by Michael Dorn, who also did, I think he was also in Star Trek, and also the Sandman in the Santa Claus movies, Santa Claus 2 and 3. I don't know if he's going to be in a series of the Santa Claus. Because I love Michael Dorn's voice. He brought Dr. Victor to life. He also did Dr. Victor from the original Ben 10 series. I fell madly in love with his voice. I really like his voice. Hopefully I get to meet him someday. And here's the Omnitrix symbol on his belt. And the two lightning spikes. Ben Victor / Frankenstein kind of resembles like Frankenstein. The movie Frankenstein. And his arms move. His head doesn't move. But his legs and arms move. And he's also from Anarch Trenzel. And he's also from the Anarch system, like from Bim Snarrow, Bim Mummy, Blitzwolfer, Ben Wolf, Ben Victor, whatever you like call him. I don't know why they're a placeholder names. Like, you don't know, like, the actual, like, name. Like, Ben doesn't, like, name them, like on screen sometimes. So, it's really hard to get, like, what names. Like, it doesn't really tell you. It just tells you at the end credit that Ben, like, named them already, like, off screen. Like, doesn't tell you what the actual aliens' names are or the transformations. So, anyway, let's get on with Upchuck. Oops, Bushuck already lost. Oops. Sorry, Bushuck. Okay, there we go. Hope that's new that again. Here we have his Upchuck. He's a Gorman 4 or Gorman 4. Uh oh. Anyway, so. Here's his tentacles out. He eats metal and spits out a glowing green goo or something, like a fireball. Like an energy beam. Don't get me wrong about the other one. So, and here's the Omnitrix symbol on his arm. And he's a really cool, good looking guy. They call him Upchuck. And he's voiced by Dave Wittenberg. He was also in that anime series, Please Teacher. I forgot the character's name that he voiced. So, Dave Wittenberg is also Upchuck. I love his voice. And he first appeared in The Visitor. And really cool guy. Really cool. And I forgot the name of this home planet, but I'm pretty sure it'll come back to me. Very green looking. got the eyes right there, got the popped out of the cartoon look. So he's one of my favorites. Like Ben actually used, I think he used him too a lot. He wasn't really used very much. So he's like a cool looking figure to add to your arsenal. So very cool, very cool. Yeah, sending them down is really hard, so. We got a close up look of most of everything. So let's get on to Ditto, my favorite one of all. He first appeared in the Divided Standard or something. And here is Ditto, and he's from the planet Hathor, and he's a Splixen, I believe. And he's voiced by Rob Paulsen, who also did Yakko Warner from the Animaniacs, and also PJ from A Goofy Movie. And in his original appearance, he was also black and white. This is his Omniverse design. He's also voiced by the same actor who did, you know what I meant. So, and his head turns, and he's not made by Bandai. I wish this was the Bandai look, what they're going for, but he's made by G Collections, a guy on Instagram who's making these figures. I think. He's doing a great job like Bandai did. So his head and his arms can move, but he's not meant to play with. He's highly collectible. So his feet move really good. I love it because Ditto was one of my favorites because he's funny, he's cute. That's what all the girls say. So anyway, so. And let's get on to Eye Guy. Here we have his Eye Guy right here. He's also voiced by D. Bradley Baker in the original. And in Omniverse, he's voiced by Paul Eiding. And he has eyes. Stare into my eyes. And he's also made by G Collections. Who's also making, I think it was planned for Bandai. Bandai was on the works of making an Eye Guy figure, but Omniverse was ending so quickly, like, they had to rush everything out, so after the Galactic Monsters arc, like, they didn't have enough time, so, like, Omniverse was ending, so. So I enjoy to like this figure. So this figure is not meant to play with. His head moves, his legs, his arms, they move. So here we got his back, his legs. So he's not meant to play with. So he's a cool guy to add in your collection. So, and here we have his. Way big. He's one of the biggest aliens of them all. I think he first appeared in the Ken 10 episode. I think it was Secret of the Omnitrix, the movie. So this is his Alien Force look. I love this figure because he's going like $100 or $200 or $300 new in box. So he's worth a lot because everyone loves White Big because it's their favorite alien. And he's a Toku star. He also lives in Cosmic Storms. His head doesn't move, but his arms move, and that's about it. It'll be cool to display him or pose him or something. So, and he's voiced by Fred Tatasciore in the original, D. Bradley Baker in Alien Force Ultimate Alien. and Eric Bosa in Omniverse, and Roger Craig Smith in the reboot, I think. So, here we go. What's that right here? Let's get on to Spitter. Here we have his Spitter, also made by G Collections. They capture, like, pretty well. Like, all the figures capture pretty well. They, like, even though he didn't appear in Omniverse, he was planned to appear in Omniverse, but they had to rush everything since the show was ending, so. His arms move, and I don't think his legs, but I think his tail moved, I think. I'm not sure. I haven't tried it out, because this is not meant to play with. So it's not meant to touch, look, and display him. And he's one of the future aliens that Ben 10,000 used. He didn't appear in the opening of Ultimate Alien. No, wait, he did appear in the opening, but he didn't appear in the, as a transformation in the episodes. He didn't appear as a transformation. So, he only appeared in the opening that Ben has available. So, he only appeared in the opening of Ultimate Alien. So, it's great to have a good looking figure like G Collections to have in your collection. I was hoping getting like 10 or like 7 more or something. So, anyway, really cool, good looking figure. I just wish he made an appearance in Omniverse. So, just to let you know, this is his Omniverse design by Derek J. Wyatt, who suddenly passed away last month, I think. Okay. Anyway, so, let's get on to Buzzshot. My newest edition. So, I've been waiting for Buzzshot, so, for a long time. Here's his Omnitrix symbol on his head. And people call him a megawatt, but he's not really a megawatt. He's a Nosian, a race of alien battery species creatures, like little guys. Like, he can like multiply of himself, like duplication, but with electricity.
Hey, I'm Buzzshot. I'm a megawatt.
I try to do my great impression of Eric Bosa or Tara Strong. So, I love his face. I love the detail. I love his eyes. Like, it brings out the, it pops out the cartoon look. Like, it's coming out, like, out of your TV or your camera. So, really, really, really cool. If you want to pause the video, be my guest so you can look at it. See, like, he resembles, like, a battery in his butt right there. And his teeth, his eyes. So, great looking figure. Love it, love it. Love it, G Collections. You did amazing, great. I'm so impressed. Anyway, so, I'm trying to make sure he doesn't tip over. Great, great, great looking figure. I think we almost have. I think we're almost done with this video. So, here's the last one. Arctiguana. Arctiguana was also one of the aliens that Ben 10,000 used. He didn't appear. Okay. As of this recording, a semi-prize. So, as of this recording, he didn't appear as a transformation in Ben 10 Ultimate Alien. He's also appeared in the opening of Ben 10 Ultimate Alien that Ben has available. And his hologram was shown in Ben 10,000 Returns as a hologram. So, this was like a surprise release by Bandai. So, I welcome one anyway. Usually the Omnitrix symbol was on his right arm or on his right, left or right arm. So, like around right here or something. And it's just like harder to see. So I love the black line connecting to his eyes. Like, I think he's like a fish and an iguana mixed together. He's a polar man lizard, and he's from the planet Xnelli. And he likes living in cold temperatures. He's the first freeze type alien that Ben 10,000 used. It wasn't the 10-year-old that debuted him. It was the future Benton, the future Ben Tennyson, the Ben 10,000. So I just love how the Black Knight is connecting to his eyes and his frozen gills. His mouth opens. Let me see if I can get it to open. There we go. See? There we go. So, great looking figure. Because this was a surprise release. I wasn't expecting one, but I woke up one anyway. So, I love it. He does come with a minifigure for the Revolution Ultimatrix. Essentially, I do have. So, anyway. So, I love it. Great job, Ben Knight. I love it. Thank you. You make my dreams come true. And other fans around the world are so happy with this. So, anyway. That's all for now. So, until next time. Halloween's coming up. I'll be volunteering at Big Texas Comic Con in my hometown, San Antonio, Texas, because I love Big Texas Comic Con. I love going to Comic Cons. I love making friends. I want to be a celebrity someday. So, tell me which is your favorite transformation, because this is my complete Ben 10 original classic transformations from 2005-2008. Because I love Arctic Iguana and Spitter and Buzzshot, because they're my favorite, because the future aliens. And also, I love Ditto as well, because they're great looking figures to have in your collection. Until next time, check out the CrazyWritersRambles.com and with Dawson Ryder, my favorite YouTube celebrity of all. Until next time, this is Mikey Blaze 18 signing out. It's Hero Time.